Hey, everybody, it's the coach. This is Madden Football on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we'll get a look at the second-year man, Sam Darnold, and the New York Jets as they take on a man miraculously back from injury, Alex Smith, and the Washington Redskins. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half, but it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Well, we've had spotty showers since about 7 a.m. here in D.C., and the radar indicates it's going to continue, but nothing to stop football from happening at FedEx Field. A few minutes ago, it sounded like the 4th of July on the National Mall as the hometown Redskins were introduced to this sold-out crowd. They are set to go as their guys will match up with the New York Jets. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, we look at this Redskin team as they interplay here. They come in feeling good after back-to-back victories. Meanwhile, for the visiting Jets, they're hitting their stride of late, winners of 3 of their last 4. The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. This one taken from the 7. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Jets work their way onto the field, led by the number 3 overall pick in 2018, Sam Darnold. And during the offseason, Darnold was asked where he was looking to improve. He told everybody, being more comfortable in the pocket. He looked back to the numbers from his rookie campaign, 17 touchdowns and 13 starts. So just imagine what a relaxed and more experienced Darnold might be able to accomplish with a stronger set of receivers now here in 2019. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play at 2nd down. And we take a look now at the New York offense.
An ankle injury that never really healed limited Quincy Nunn's production in 2018, but expect that to bounce back this season. Tough, productive downfield player. He can make a lot of catches, even with people in his face.
Now a deep ball there on 2nd down, but it'll wind up incomplete. He was trying to find his tight end, Chris Herndon, and it's 3rd down. Time for a look at our starters here on defense. We know they're going to be tough to throw on. Top 3 in the NFL defending the pass.
Yeah, defending the pass hasn't been an issue for them. It's been stopping the run. And if they don't stop the run, they can't get back to their strength, which is guarding against the air attack.
After an incomplete pass on 2nd down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. Now throwing on 3rd down there, but he cannot connect. So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And it'll be Redskins football now with a 1st and 10. Alex Smith ready to lead the Redskins here. And many wondered if Smith would ever play again following that difficult-to-watch leg injury suffered against the Texans last season. But at age 35, Smith is back and ready to give it another go. Smith and the Redskins will come up now 1st and 10 at their own 23.
Check 26.
Now a man in his 13th NFL season. It's Adrian Peterson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give the Redskins 13 there and a 1st down.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
To throw is Smith. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. The safety Marcus May in there on the coverage. And a quick look at Washington's offense.
One thing for us to keep in mind and remember, they're coming off of their open week last week. They got to sit home and relax a little bit before the final stretch of the season. they got the lucky draw because every team in the league wants to have that open week later in the year rather than early. They benefited.
Open man is Quinn. He completes it. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. A look now at the defensive starters for the Jets. In that win last week over the Giants, they were very good.
And what I saw on film was nearly an unstoppable pass rush. They had 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries. So now do you just max protect on offense, keep everyone in and run, you know, one or two receiver routes to make sure your quarterback stays up? We'll soon find out.
Throwing on third down, Smith. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Intended for Paul Richardson. Incomplete.
Well, it's easy to see when we review this that the ball needs to come out quicker, because if you don't throw it right on the break, you bring a crowd of people into the equation.
And that's why it got knocked away there. And now the punter, Tress Way, as he sends this one away. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. Darnold going to lead the Jets up now, 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Darnold from the gun. It's caught by Quincy Anunua. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. That's good for a Jet first down, a gain of 13. On first down, it's Powell. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Sean Dion Hamilton was there to bring him down defensively. Looking to throw on second down. Darnold. He's going to find his tight end. That's Chris Herndon. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. In Washington territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 44-yard line. This is the running back, Powell. And he's able to carve out about 6 there, down to the 37.
Right there. He was taken right there.
Go, go, go.
A 6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4.
A first carry for Trenton Cannon. Down the numbers. There he goes. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Trenton Cannon, his first touchdown on the year, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Well, these guys have won 3 straight ball games and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
The point after, through the raindrops, up and good, and it's now a 7-0 game. So the drive there, 5 plays, 80 yards. And the last play, a really nice run that culminated in the touchdown. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. A huge play there for Washington. 46 yards.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. The big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, 1st and 10. A shotgun snap for Smith. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down. So now they'll come up on 2nd and 10 once again from the 28.
Four down, four down, four down.
This is Chris Thompson in his seventh season now as a Redskin. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8.
He was brought down by Marcus May. That's a gain of 7. Brings up 3rd and 3.
Back to the ground. This time it's Peterson. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. And now time will be called here as we've got an injured Redskin down on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back.
Let's go now. 60 outlaw.
54. Light 54.
Let's go, tight end. Let's go right here now.
Yeah, shit.
Ready?
They'll run on first down. Thompson. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's 2nd and 11. Now a quick pass to Richardson. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Here's Smith to throw on third down. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It's way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
Hopkins' kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they put together a good little drive there, but ultimately stalling out in the red zone.
Yeah, I know a lot of people look at it as a little bit of a negative. They didn't get 6 points out of it, right? Didn't get the touchdown. But that's actually okay. They got 3 points. It will give their defense a little bit of rest, let them settle down over there. So all in all, to me, that's a good drive.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in. So a lot to fight for.
Yeah, and wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff that they all made sure to let us know, we know where we are right now, but the playoffs don't start tomorrow. We still got some time, and they plan on putting it together, formulating a streak, and the whole month of December still left to play. They think they can get in.
And they made it very obvious to us that there's no playoff talk in the locker room right now. It's win this game and look to next week.
Excellent focus.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A Jet first down, 18 big yards that time.
And the Jets first down.
On 1st and 10, Darnold. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked, but instead they'll keep it on 2nd down.
It leads to 2nd and 10.
Hey, we got 3 down, 3 down.
On 2nd down, it's Powell. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for 3rd down. Could be 4 down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on. Now the ball comes loose into the Redskins. Have it, they do.
We're going to shut you down.
And hopefully for both sides, not a sign of things to come, Charles. I mean, this morning, it was so perfect outside, but we knew this weather was coming, and we see the effects of it here early on.
And I wonder if how perfect it was this morning has psychologically fooled everyone. You know, it's almost like even though we were told the weather was coming, and you know the teams knew it as well, that maybe they got fooled and thought, ah, it's going to be okay. And now they're probably a little upset that it's out there.
Because warm-ups were dry.
Oh, well, dry. Now you've got to make the change up, and it's the first quarter. Might take them a little time to settle in on their focus and concentration.
A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Smith on 1st down. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on 2nd and 10. Throwing is Smith, and that's incomplete. Maybe a little over-anxious in the pocket there. He just didn't look comfortable on that throw.
No, he didn't, because it wasn't his normal fluid delivery. And I think you might have had it right. Wasn't really confident with what he saw downfield and almost felt like he wanted to pull that one back.
And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 27-yard line. On first down, it's Thompson. He's able to get six, a nice pickup down to the 21. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four.
Complete. Richardson has it. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the five and keep it moving.
The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10. Shotgun handoff to Thompson. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Read it. 54, right there, 54, Mike.
Stay with your man.
Get it. On second and 12, Smith. He's got Thompson here, complete. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Call it a 3-yard gain, and they're going to have a third down. Smith.
So many times you hear today.
He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Leonard Williams. Make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
Well, it's about how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal? That's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down.
Dustin Hopkins on for the field goal. A 37-yard attempt.
And Hopkins' kick is good. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So two first quarter field goal attempts for him, and he's converted on both.
I like the positive right there. 2 for 2, got the points on the board. The negative side is they didn't score touchdowns. And of course, going forward in this game, that's going to be the aim. And hopefully, he'll be kicking extra points instead.
This is taken at his 4. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Now whistles, and we've got a man down. A man down here following the kickoff. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. They'll run on first down. Powell. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. After one, a one-point game, 7-6. Now off the bootleg, Darnold. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Darnold. And that will be incomplete.
Well, he'll definitely say that that's one he should have held on to. But when you're playing in elements like this, sometimes those bullet passes, those ones with a little bit of pace on them, they can be difficult to hold on to.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. They've given him some touches. They haven't had a lot of success on the ground. Do you maybe keep going to that well, or do you mix it up more?
I think you mix it up more, try and loosen things up. Get the defense to react to other people, other plays, but don't forget about it. That's your horse. You know, Secretariat lost twice in his career.
So educational. That's very true, kids. Look it up. Good work after the catch. Gets him 15 and a first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Throwing on second and 14. Smith, that's going to be caught by Richardson. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. The Redskins on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 4. From the 50, it's Smith. And that is incomplete. Intended for Josh Dotson.
Incomplete. Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
Bilal Powell and his offensive mates retaking the field. He's hoping to get it going. They're hoping to get him going, too. You know, he's about ready to pop one here in the second quarter. He's hoping.
And his offensive line teammates, they want to get one of those too because they want to continue to run the football. Most offensive linemen like that part of the game better than pass protection because they're not taking blows, they're actually dealing them out. So what they want to do is show the coaches, hey, if we pop one, we're having success. That way they won't go away from the running game.
He'll be hoping to pop one, break one here this go around. 7 yards there and a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now it's Darnold. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Ryan Kerrigan racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes, the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
On second down now, it's Powell. They get 2 yards back, but they're going to need a lot more than that here on third down. The Jets on third down, they've only converted once in 4 tries. This is third and 16. Darnold now to throw. Gets it to his running back, Cannon.
Well, that's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Fielded at the 20. That'll wind up being a 50-yard punt, though they do get 10 back on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He's just been looking for some space. Yeah, I'm not going to pin it on him or the offensive line, but they need to get this run game going better.
Sometimes you just have to credit the defense. They came in with a plan themselves. So I think now you try and mix things up a little bit. Get the ball in the hands of some other people, find some other playmakers, but always let the defense believe that he's still a threat.
I was going to say, don't forget about
it. No, don't take him totally out of the game.
The last catch did get 3, but they're still left needing 7 yards on third down. From the gun, here's Smith. It's hauled in by Dotson. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Smith finding Dotson that time for a Washington first. On first and 10, Smith. He's got his man. This is Dotson. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. That'll wind up going for a loss of four. And it'll bring up a second and 14. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long.
Right there.
Smith throwing again. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Again, Smith. And he drops this off to Thompson, complete. And he can only manage to get this to the 45-yard line, well short of the first.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they've rallied and made the tackle.
Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
Gets this to the 24 for a gain of four. The Jets on third down, just one for five to this point. This will be third and six. Out of the shotgun, here's Darnold. And he's got a noon one. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a six-yard pickup on third down.
Many teams, as soon as they spot man defense, if they haven't called a hitch, they'll get to it as fast as they can. They want to put the ball in the hands of one of their best playmakers and hope that he can break a tackle on the outside and go for big yardage.
And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives them a new set of downs. On first down, it's Darnold. Open is Powell. That's complete. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Here's Darnold. He can't avoid the pressure. Redskins get there. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
He's able to hit Joshua Bellamy. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A big third down conversion with a gain of 28.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
I used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
Holding offense.
So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that can be the make or break difference on a play. This time you had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. I think you'd agree that looked like the right call from up here.
No doubt about it. What everyone has to understand is that the officials are going to be right on the play each and every time. You may not like the call, but they're usually spot on.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Quincy Anunua couldn't reel that one in. That'll bring up second down. Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. To throw is Darnold. That one's complete to Tomlinson. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Redskins' 17-yard line. Darnold now, 10 of 17 throwing the ball. He's got a first and 10. And he's heating up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. That'll be taken in by Anderson. And he's brought down. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. They go play action here on first down. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7.
Well, that was their third sack of the ball game. Second in the league in sacks coming into this one. They're planning on making it a race to the top, aren't they?
Absolutely. They're looking up at that top spot, but they might be looking down at the second spot pretty soon. Second down and goal. Darnold to the goal line, but it's incomplete. DRC, Dominic Rogers, Cromartie getting in there to break it up. Now Darnold on third and goal. Powell on the catch. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. The Redskins now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Catanzaro's kick is good. And they bump the lead up to 4 now at 10-6. That will go down as a 15-play drive, and it results in 3 points. So some disappointment?
It's funny. We had our conference before the game with the offensive coordinator. And what did he tell us? I just want every drive to end in a kick, right? An extra point, a punt, or a field goal. Well, in this case, I think it is a little bit of a disappointment because it did end in a kick, but that type of a drive should end in the end zone.
Smith on first down. And lucky to get away with one there. That one nearly picked. Second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Now Smith going to throw again. He's got it complete to Thompson. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. Now Washington going to use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts. Now it's Smith. As the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number 1.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number 1 thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. The offense trots back onto the field, and we shine our Madden spotlight on Sam Darnold. And I guess the question, Charles, is what's the formula for keeping him better protected? Because as we see, the protection, it struggled.
And normally what you get is renewed determination. When the big guy gets hit, that usually sparks people. Hey, we can't let this happen anymore. They take it personally. He's not supposed to be on the ground, but that hasn't been the case so far in this game. So maybe they've got to figure out how do they get rid of the ball faster to help out the offensive line so he doesn't get hit as much.
And we'll see if they can keep him off the ground now going forward. Great coverage there all around. Really didn't have many options to throw the football.
Very little chance that one was going to be completed. Every receiver was locked up.
It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Darnold with a draw play, gives to Powell. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. A solid run on 1st down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3. A final shot before the break, Darnold. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's 3rd down. So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, there you have it. Halftime quickly over. 3rd quarter, here we go. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the 2nd half. This is taken at the 3. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. A reminder that coming up later tonight, a good one on Sunday Night Football. We'll see what could have been a playoff matchup a season ago. The Bears and the Rams from L.A. And then tomorrow night, Monday Night Football from down in Mexico. Mexico City, to be precise. The Chiefs and the Chargers going at it. The tackle there by Brian Poole. Again, a run with Thompson. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. He's got Thompson here, complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards is the pickup, and it's good for a Washington first down. On first down, it's Thompson. Now a loose football. The ball comes out, and it's scooped up by the Jets. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jets.
Touchdown, baby.
We know this defense has some playmakers. We saw it right there. Well, really, we've seen it the whole game.
Isn't it nice to see that on the opposite side of the ball? Respect, my man. Respect. The defensive guys are outscoring their opposing offense.
Yeah, they're outscoring him indeed with that score alone. Point after now from Catanzaro. It's good, and now it's an 11-point lead, 17-6.
Makes the score Jets 17.
The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for six. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. Smith and the Redskins will come up now first and 10 at their own 27. Throwing is Smith. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. He was looking for Paul Richardson there, and that'll bring up second down.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 10 yards there, good for a Redskin first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
On first down, here's Love, and he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of three.
He was brought down by Adrian Williamson. A 3-yard pickup brings up second and 7 at the 40-yard.
Here's a throw out wide to Quinn.
13 yards on the play.
Let's go. So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 47. Off of play action, here's Smith. And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down.
Second down and 10.
Watch the backer, watch the backer.
On second down, it's Thompson.
Go, go, go.
19 yards the pickup there. Move the chains.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
They'll run on first down. Love. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8.
8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and 2.
They go quickly here out to Daxon. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. Got a man, that's Quinn. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It'll be a loss of one, and that's going to make it fourth down.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though. Huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
So it's a third field goal for him now. He's accounted for all 9 points. I look down to the sideline, though. You can just tell they weren't too happy for three. They wanted six.
So they have to have six. Look, he's keeping them afloat, but they really need to do exactly what you talked about. They need to get into the end zone and score some touchdowns. Otherwise, you have to kick a lot more field goals than just the three he's already put through the post.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else. I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. On first and 10, Darnold. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down. On second and 10, Darnold. And he's got this complete to Bellamy. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Now they'll try to convert on third and 6 after the 4-yard completion. Throwing again is Darnold. And the throw there going to be incomplete. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
You rarely call your punter a weapon, but he certainly was there. How about that? Pinning him down at the 1-yard line and helping out the defense in a big way. I'm telling you what, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I might be thinking safety right now.
First play of the drive is a run with Thompson. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
He was brought down by Avery Williamson. It's a gain of 9.
They go with Thompson again. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line.
A gain of 3 yards. Right there. 54. Right there. 54. First down.
On first down, this is Geis. And he takes us across the 15 to the 17. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. From the 17, Smith. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. He was looking for Paul Richardson there.
Okay, partner. No surprise to you. I'm going to look at this from the defensive perspective. In the rain, you have to be more cautious trying to cover passing routes. Why? The offense knows where they're going with the football. The receiver knows the route he's going to run. You have to make sure you keep your footing underneath you.
So here are the Jets now to take over. They're on a 3-game winning streak, and right now looking good in this one as well. After the interception, here's Darnold. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Ryan Kerrigan, he's the culprit, and that is now his 13th sack of the season as his great year continues.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. On the draw, here's Powell. Down to about the 22 here. So they've been unable to capitalize on the great field position as of yet. Here's 3rd and 9. They'll fake the handoff. Now Darnold. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And it's incomplete, broken up. But there is a flag down. Let's see what that's about. So the pass incomplete in the end zone, but contact and pass interference.
And now where does the ball get placed?
At the 1-yard line.
1-yard line. They gave up.
Fighting his way in for a Jets touchdown. Bilal Powell, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jets capitalize on the short field as they take it in for 6.
Well, he got a little bit of everything on that run. Offensive line creating some space, but how about the guy running behind his pads into the end zone?
What does that mean when a guy says running behind his pad?
It means that he's going to be a physical runner. That way he's able to use his shoulder pads, his forearms, anything to ward off people to power his way forward.
Catanzaro now for the extra point. And the lead is up to 15 now.
Makes the score Jets 24.
The drive there only spanning 3 plays. And it's finished off by the touchdown run coming from Bilal Powell. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. Throwing on 3rd down, Smith. And that will be incomplete.
Intended for Vernon Davis. Incomplete.
Had to pass there, 3rd and long on your own side of the field. Just couldn't come up with anything.
That's why teams always talk about having to win the early downs, meaning you've got to gain yardage and set yourself up for 3rd and short, because when it's 3rd and long, the odds go down significantly trying to pick up the 1st down, even throwing the football.
A 48-yard punt, 7 on the return. And the Jets will take over 1st and 10. So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Darnold throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Josh Bellamy, the intended receiver, but it's going to be 2nd down. 2nd and 10 from the 33-yard line. Powell takes it from Darnold. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Give him 4 on the ground there. They're now left with 3rd and 6. Throwing here on 3rd down. Darnold. Hard throw, incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely, just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. And after a sluggish start, he's really bounced back. The numbers bear that out.
And you're a baseball guy, partner. How many at-bats over the course of a baseball season?
Oh, boy, 4 in a game.
Yeah, about the 4 in a game.
4 times 162.
350 or so, right? Sometimes it takes a while for a guy to get going. That's my point. It's not the first few carries. You don't worry about that. As they go along, get that guy lathered up, get those blocking assignments down. Those 2-yard gains turn into bigger gains as the game moves along.
Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's 3rd down. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Half the distance there, so that moves the ball from the 6 all the way back to the 3. So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, 3rd and long. And he's able to get this one up to the 8-yard line this time. It'll be a gain of 5, and the punt team will now come out on 4th down. Here's Tressway now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good.
Let's go, baby. Let's go.
Before they can get the punt away, whistles as we've come to the end of the third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now they're going to get about three here out of this first down run, and that'll bring up second and seven. Ryan Kerrigan in on the tackle. From the 44, Darnold, open his pal, that's complete. A one-yard gain there following the three-yard pickup on first down. From the gun on third down, here's Darnold. Finds his target, it's Bellamy. And he will have the first down as he gets this to the 47. 8 yards, first down as they're able to convert. On first down, it's Darnold. Herndon's got it, complete. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock, and this is second and less than a yard. Powell. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Give him 15 yards on that one, and the Jets move the chains.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one, despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
Darnold completes it, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. On second down now, it's Powell. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he stopped immediately there. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. Now off the bootleg, Darnold. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? A shotgun snap for Darnold. Completes it to Powell. The third down run gets him nothing. Now they couldn't get anything going there out on the right side in the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the
big
passing
emphasis.
Game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
So with that, you figure, yeah, this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down, but don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 12 yards is the pickup, and it's good for a Washington first down. To throw is Smith.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Smith.
He's second in the NFL in interceptions, and you understand why. He plays a game of great intelligence, understands positioning, and has a great ability to break on the football when it's in the air.
So fun to watch his closing speed, and another example of it on that play. On first down, Smith. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for Paul Richardson there. And now it's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now it's Smith. And this one complete to Reed. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. From the 50, it's Smith. And he finds McLaurin. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 36. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Again, Smith. And finding Davis here, the tight end. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5 yard or a 15 yard inadvertent or not. Now it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
They run it here with Thompson. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. They'll keep it on the ground. Thompson, and he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Chris Thompson, his first touchdown on the year. And the Redskins are able to cut into that deficit.
And that touchdown ends a streak, for lack of a better word, of 3 field goals that they put on the board previously. They finally cracked the code.
Yeah, they've been down there. They've been in enemy territory, as you said. They just hadn't been able to punch it in until that point. Extra point good by Hopkins. And that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it's capped off by a touchdown run of 6 yards. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And New York set to take the field. Now, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
They begin with a carry for Powell. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Holding offense.
So on the big tight end, holding.
Each and every year, we talk about very few tight ends coming into the league that are polished blockers or asked to do it a lot in college. So it's a constant struggle and a constant fight to learn how to do it without holding.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for. And it's second down.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline. But do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. That'll be good for 6, but now it's fourth down.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Smith and the Redskins will come up now, first and 10 at their own 18. To Thompson on the draw. And he'll take this forward for 2, maybe 3. But we do have a flag down, and they're already marching backward. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. A shotgun snap for Smith. And he hits the tight end. It's Davis. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. They'll give him 8 on the play, and it'll be second and 11. Under 4 to go now as the clock runs, and they come up on second down. Here's Smith. This one caught by Davis. And they'll get him down here at the 23. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. They face a third and four after that last completion gets them six. This is Love. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down. Well, look at the clock. You're down two scores. Have to go for this, don't you?
And they thought that as soon as they took over possession. It didn't matter where they were on the field. They were always going to be in four down territory, backed up, in good situation. It didn't matter. So they've been preparing for that on their play sheet the entire time.
Now on fourth down here, that pass knocked away and incomplete. Ryan Poole that time there to get a hand on it. So now with a two-minute warning coming up fast, that puts a mammoth dent in their comeback hopes.
I like how you phrased it. It's a dent because there's still opportunity. They've got to get the ball back on defense, obviously twice. But guess what? This thing is not close to being over. They need to go ahead and play it out.
Not over. As you said, two-score game still. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Oh, yeah, I'm coming. Oh, yeah, I'm coming.
And Darnold wants to throw the football. And Darnold, he lost the football. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. They run with Powell. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. The Redskins going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. They go again with Powell. And he'll be tackled right on the 10, well short of the first down. And he gets a good chunk of yards there, 8 all told. But they're still looking at a fourth down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
The kick is good. Makes the score Jets 30.
So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but they still ate up time, got points, so while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense.
No, it's out. Smith lost it. But the Redskins look to get this one back, and indeed they did. It's still Washington football. Throwing on second and long, Smith. That catch good for five. It's third down. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here. Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game, but these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast ahead of time? Are you one of those guys that's skeptical about it, or did you trust it?
But when I saw just a big blob of green on the radar, I said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice, got your notes laminated, because, you know, open-air booth, that rain can affect us as well, although not as much as the guys on the field. But let's face it, it's kind of fun to watch these types of games, isn't it?
It is. By the way, how impressive is it that you travel with a laminator? I didn't even know there was a portable laminator.
The things that you learn.
Golly, wise beyond his years. So for the Jets, it's a win that might keep them alive in the playoff race as they're back to 500 at 5-5. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for Washington, it was a game they really needed as they drop back to 4-6. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week.